God is in his holy place. God who unites those who dwell in his house. He himself gives might and strength to his people.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us humbly acknowledge our sins as we now prepare our hearts to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, and what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
We adore you, we glorify you.
Father, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that, with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast, even now, to those that endure forever. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Kings. The Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream at night. God said, "Ask something of me, and I will give it to you." Solomon answered, "O Lord, my God, you have made me your servant, king to succeed my father David. But I am a mere youth, not knowing at all how to act. I serve you in the midst of the people whom you have chosen, a people so vast that it cannot be numbered or counted. Give your servants, therefore, an understanding heart to judge your people and to distinguish right from wrong. For who is able to govern this vast people of yours?" The Lord was pleased that Solomon made this request. So God said to him, "Because you have asked for this, not for a long life for yourself, nor for riches, nor for the life of your enemies, but for understanding, so that you may know what is right, I do as you requested. I give you a heart so wise and understanding that there has never been anyone like you up to now. And after you, there will come no one equal to you." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I have said all.
from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, we know that all things work for good for those who love God, who are called according to his purpose. For those he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, so that he might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. And those he predestined, he also called. And those he called, he also justified. And those he justified, he also glorified. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Like a treasure buried in a field, which a man finds and hides once again, and out of joy goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant searching for fine pearls. When he finds a pearl of great price, he goes and sells all that he has and buys it. Do you understand all these things? They answered, yes. And Jesus replied, then every scribe who has been instructed in the kingdom of heaven is like the head of a household who brings from his storeroom both the new and the old. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
It's often been said that all of us, everyone loves a winner. We may feel sorry for a loser, but we don't have a lot of admiration for them. Stories like someone winning the lottery, the Powerball, make many of us pause and think, what would I do with all of that money? Or that show on HGTV where million-dollar winners, and they may win $10 million, and this guy comes in and helps them buy and build and fix up a beautiful home. So honestly, all of us, I think, have that dream at some point or other. What would I do if I had all that money? Quite honestly, though, I think that there may be a part of all of us, when we hear of someone hitting it big, that's filled with a tiny bit of jealousy and envy. Why them and not me? Why should they win and not me?
Why, God? The parable today of the man who sold all he had to gain a field where he found a treasure. The parable of the pearl of great price, that the man sells everything he has to buy that lustrous pearl, beautiful pearl. The Lord tells these to force us to look at our lives and to ask a question or two. What would we give or sell to gain such earthly treasures? How often have I, quote unquote, sold myself and my values to gain something that I desire in this world? He's not only talking about money. He's talking about something much, much more important. What about our personal integrity, our Catholic values and truths, our own self-worth? Have I ever sold out to cultural pressure in order to simply get by, to feel accepted, to feel part of the group, especially in days like we live in today? The Lord is trying to get us to think about, in light of all of the above, what am I willing to give or sell, not for something earthly, but for the kingdom of God? In other words, my immortal soul. Do I wish to buy the entire field that is the kingdom of God, eternal life, the Lord Jesus, or merely an acre or two? In other words, am I willing to profess my Catholic faith, but do I truly live it 24/7, not just at Mass, not when it's convenient, not when it's particularly correct or incorrect? Am I a parent? Do I pass on the pearl of my Catholic faith in all of its fullness to my sons, my daughters? I am afraid that all of us forget that following the Lord is a daily life. It's a daily challenge. It's a daily joy. It's not something that we trot out when we need something. It's not something that we show in order to make a good impression. At times, it's easy. Most times, we need a good kick in the butt to get going, to put it quite frankly. And I could have used other words in other languages, but you get the point. Did you ever notice in the parables tonight that the Lord did not continue until the end? We're left wondering, which is a good thing, really, in relationship of these parables to ourselves. What did the man who sold everything to buy the field with the hidden treasure do once he bought that field? He sold everything. And here is this field, and it's got a buried treasure of some sort in it. What could he do with it? He didn't have his house. He didn't have property anymore outside of this field. He couldn't spend the treasure. He had buried it for now. So what did he do? What about the man who gained the lustrous, beautiful pearl beyond price? Beautiful gem, beautiful thing. Imagine a big pearl. But what did he do? He had sold everything. Was he going to sell the pearl in order to live? Or did he just keep it sitting on the street corner? We're left wondering, did they hoard these things, or did they use them for the benefit of others and themselves? You and I are so gullible to have a good show, something that appears so beautiful that we don't even consider the consequences if we go for it. You know the devil likes to work that way. You know you want it. Go for it. You deserve it. Buy it, sell it, use that person, doesn't matter, You want it? You deserve it. Who'll ever know? Jesus turns it around and asks, what price will you offer to follow me? What treasure in your fields, what lustrous pearl of your life are you willing to surrender in order to give your life to obtain eternal life? All of us like treasures. All of us like to buy things. That's not the issue. The issue is, what do we do with it after we have it? Do we let it control us? Or do we simply use it, fully aware that it's a gift, that God gives us the means to have things? My Catholic faith, it's a free gift from God that I embrace. Do I use it? Or do I simply claim it and never use it? And so we ask ourselves, what's the most important field of treasure? What is the pearl of great price for me, for you, that you're willing to sell yourself in order to obtain? You're willing to sell your soul for this treasure, for this pearl. It better be the treasure and the pearl that is Jesus Christ. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
My brothers and sisters, united in the Lord Jesus, we profess now our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Trusting in the Lord, who told Solomon, ask something of me, and I will grant it. Let us now call to mind these our prayers.
For the followers of Christ, united with Pope Francis, that we will value our Catholic faith as the pearl of great price, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the saving wisdom of God will come to rulers of nations and communities and shape their thoughts and actions for justice, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a spirit of discernment, that we may abandon what is evil and hold firm to what is good, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a generous increase in vocations to the priesthood and religious life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the eternal happiness of God will come to those who have died and be their treasure forever, We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, you form us in your own image. You shower us with love, compassion, and justice. Help us to share these gifts with others as we love them, as we love you. Grant this in all of our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to mankind's fallen state, and by his suffering canceled out our sins. By his resurrection from the dead he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with a company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end, we acclaim.
Oh,
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mysterium fidei.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, O Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, O Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Charles, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Michael, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At our Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, O Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity
in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God, and behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and never forget all his benefits. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all my being bless his holy name. He pardons all your iniquities, heals all your ills. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and never forget all his benefits. He redeems your life from destruction. He crowns you with kindness and compassion. He fills your lifetime with good. Your youth is renewed like the eagles. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and never forget all his benefits.
Shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak no words in foreign lands, and all will understand.
Let us pray. We have consumed, O God, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of Jesus Christ, your Son. Grant, we pray, that this holy gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may profit us for eternal salvation through the same Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
St. Michael, the archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.